In this video, we will begin with loft command in AutoCAD. You can start loft command from home tab in modeling panel, or you can type LOF for loft at command prompt and press enter. At first, we will create some geometry in 2D. Click here, select a polygon, give a number of sides. In this case, I want 6 sides and press enter. Then create a circle also at the center. Lastly, create a rectangle. Make sure the rectangle is placed at the center. Now switch to 3D modeling and go to this unshaped bar right on top of view panel. Choose SE isometric and also click this 2D wireframe. Select shaded. Now let's separate these profiles. Type M to initiate move command. Press enter. Select this circle. Press enter again. Turn ortho mode on. Give direction. Similarly, move this object to the top of these entities. So let's take a copy of this object. For that, type CO at command prompt and press enter. Select the entities and press enter. Select the base point. Turn ortho mode off. Now we will apply loft. So go to home key. Click this fly out. Choose loft. Select this rectangle. Connect to this circle and this pentagon. Press enter. More options are available, but let's take cross section. And if you change the sequence of selection for loft, it will create different object. Click loft, then select the first and last object, then the middle object and press enter. Enter again. Let's do more examples. Take a circle and second another circle, then separate them. Place small circle at the center. For this, we will add a polyline passing through the centers of each circle. Now apply loft command. For that, type LOF at command prompt and press enter. Choose point option, then the end point of this polyline. Don't click, track it, then click outside. Now select this top circle, center circle, and last circle and press enter. Enter again. We can also do with the rectangle base. First, let's make the entities. Now here we have rectangle base. Same way, join all the entities starting from top all the way down. So we will come up this beautiful geometry. Next example, we will take a rectangle base, but first create a line of this shape. We will have to fillet this sharp end. Choose fillet, type R for radius, then give radius. Click both the lines. Now we will have to join all the lines, otherwise we cannot apply loft. It will show error if we try to loft it. For this, use join command to join these entities. Type join at command prompt and press enter. Select object and press enter. As you can see here, it is a single polyline. Now we will add a small rectangle at the bottom. Make sure the end point of the line should be at the center, and top end we will add a circle. Before that, let's change the view to y-axis, which will be front. Now add circle at its center attached to the circle. Let's select loft. Choose the first object and second object. Press enter, then choose path. Then select the line as our path. You can orbit it to see it clearly. You can choose different look or style by clicking this flyout and choose these options. Say I want to select ruled option. This is how it will look. Now change to smooth fit. Similarly, you have normal to all section and normal to start section. Each selection has different look. After that, press escape to complete your selection. So this was all about loft command in AutoCAD.